Lately, I've been researching about how my home in Hillsboro fits into the larger Tualatin watershed, and I've learned some pretty interesting things about our native pollinators. Did you know that about 1 in 3 bites of food that you take requires a pollinator to even exist? If we didn't have pollinators, we wouldn't have any more coffee, no more avocados, no more fruits like apples, peaches, and grapes. These little creatures are essential to the world and all of human life, so I want to know how to make them as happy and comfortable as I can. To find out how, I asked Lorena O'Neill from the Backyard Habitat Certification Program to tell me all about pollinators and how to create the perfect environment for them with some plants that she picked out for me. Here she comes. Hi, Lorena.
Hi, Dylan.
How are you?
Very good, thank you.
Good. So, what is the Backyard Habitat Certification Program?
The Backyard Habitat Certification Program encourages urban gardeners just like yourself to create natural habitats in the properties they live in. We do this by assessing 5 elements of the criteria, which is noxious plants, native plants, stormwater management, wildlife stewardship, and pesticide reduction. The program awards 3 levels of certification: silver, gold, or platinum, depending on how many boxes you check in each of the 5 elements. The program is so important, Dylan, because it helps us think, what is our place in the ecosystem and how our home or the places we live fit into the watershed.
So how do you keep track of all these backyard habitats?
Through qualified technicians just like me. I'm one of those people that will come out to do a site assessment of your property, not just the backyard. Do you know this program is available for Washington County residents?
Oh, that's great. Maybe I should apply.
Absolutely.
I will. So I've got this strip here by my driveway. Can you tell me about why you picked some of these particular plants?
Well, when it's not raining, this area gets a lot of sun. So a variety of plants that include Willamette Valley natives, such as this, will do great for this spot.
So what kind of pollinators do we have here in Washington County?
Around here, we have so many different types of pollinators, Dylan. Native solitary bees, bumblebees, hummingbirds, moths, butterflies, just to give you an example. Did you know that in the U.S., most of our native bees are ground nestings, not hive dwellers?
Oh, I had no idea. So what can I do to entice pollinators to my garden?
Pollinators give us a lot, and they need just a few things to thrive. They need foraging areas with a variety of native plants that have overlapping bloom times. They need partially bare ground for nesting, woody vegetation, mud, leaves, things like that.
That sounds pretty cozy. So what kind of plants should I be looking for to create that environment?
It's no surprise native pollinators love native plants. Ideally, you would have plants that are blooming throughout the year. For example, we have Oregon sunshine, lupin, asters, and columbine. Bigleaf lupin is a host for various butterflies and is visited by bumblebees and hummingbirds.
Sounds like pollinators have their own favorite foods like us.
They do. I can't wait to see what you do with this area.
Yeah, me neither. Thanks. Hey, keep an eye out for my Backyard Habitat Certification application.
I will. And if you need more information, visit tualatinswcd.org or backyardhabitats.org.
Well, I'm super happy with how this turned out. I can't wait to have Lorena back to see if I qualify for Backyard Habitat Certification.